was on my way here anyway. I'm the host of the show. Yeah. Okay, all right. Quiet coyotes. Quiet coyotes. Look, I'm the host. I was just like a master of ceremonies, you know, like Dick Clark at New Year's. Oh, rest in peace. Bob Barker, Price is Right. Oh, rest in peace. Ryan Seacrest, we're working on it. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and start, but you look great. I love this whole Dr. Quinn medicine woman look you got going on. So let's get started. Hey everyone, I'm your host. I'm sorry I am late. I was actually hired back in August, but I've been trying to park since Tuesday.
Silence!
Oh, damn, girl, you want an outro line?
Mr. Payne, it is time for the sacrifice. So here we are. Fixed progress. Now, I know that any true blood fan of this spooky, kooky musical extravaganza knows that our shows are famous for three specific things. Sexy dancers. Oh, my. Oh. The American Girl Hooker Doll. We're also famous for powerful singers. Yes, when you're standing close, it's not as fun. And of course, the most famous thing, the thing that people enjoy the most about our show, once the lights go down, hand jobs at the back section. Let's bring up the lights. A hand job check. Oh, I see a lot of frisky teenagers back there. Several questionable adults. Yes, if you sit next to the right person, it's the best ride in the park. Now, oh, it can be. Like, I can't remember his name. You, sir, with the glasses and the mostly bald head, from what I can see, the back row of this one set. Yet the woman just laid her head on you in shame, which I completely understand. What's your name, sir, again, yelled out? Did you have to check with her first? I mean, you've got a driver's license. You can look at that. It's Angel, everyone! Well, I tell you what, Angel is no angel in the balcony, I can tell you that. Yes, he's a legend here. As Angel, we used to call him Repeat Offender. And, I'm going to show you just exactly. Oh, young lady, how old are you? 6! Are you with your parents? Oh, here you are, 6-year-old and me without a Parent of the Year trophy to hand out. Let that applause be your reward. My time here is at an end because there's booze in my dressing room, but we are about to go into a period of history, an illustrious period in Knott's Scary Farm's past. A time when the specter of Jack the Ripper haunted the mazes and stages of our park to London!
Thank you. to sit next to Angel.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Let me hear y'all howl! I love the sound of bitches in heat. I'm still talking about you, Angel. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I gotta tell you something. I'm a little worried. That's right, Wolfman Jack is a little worried. When I came bouncing out here on stage, some of you were very excited, but some of you I saw. Your eyes got wide. Your jaw dropped down. A chill went up and down your spine, and you thought to yourself, who the fuck is Wolfman Jack? Well, that's all right. I don't mind reintroducing myself once every few decades. You see, I was a famous disc jockey back in the day. I spun records from Los Angeles all the way down to Mexico. How about that? Yeah, oh, that's a trunk of the couple there. Now, I gotta tell you, music has changed a lot though. You know, back in my day, we had the classic artists. We had Fleetwood Mac and the Rolling Stones and the Beatles. Now you got Lizzo, but me, Mrs. Kool-Aid, bitch slapping her dancers around. And back then, you know, we spun vinyl records. Now what you got? You got streaming? When I was young, if I found out I was streaming, I went to the doctor and got some antibiotics. But that is all right, because I am so glad all of you are here tonight, even you, Six. Hey, Six, what do you want to be when you grow up other than in therapy? Check with your, oh, what?
A doctor.
A doctor. Oh, good. I'm dead. Too late for me. But we may have a job for you by the end of the night. Now, ladies and gentlemen, all right. I am so excited about the music we're about to spin for you right now, because over the years, Not Scary Bomb has played upon your deepest and darkest fears. We have terrorized you with clowns. We have traumatized you with zombies. But nothing, no, nothing will prepare you for the Doll Factory. Now, Wolfman, he doesn't like creepy dolls. That's why I always bring my own. This is, yeah, thank you. This is Pamela. We are in a polyamorous relationship with a pool floaty. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. The Wolfman is out. Wolf just went in.
Thank you.
moved off of Zach Galifianakis. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. I really appreciate you. Know, if I had a heart, it would be so warm right now. Not as warm as Angel's general pelvic region, but pretty warm. Now, in case any of you don't know who I am, and you certainly can't tell from that guy, I'm Dr. Cleaver. I hosted shows here in this theater for many years. I've also done shows over at the Birdcage Theater, the one that in the summer smells like a dead cat's ass, and in the winter smells like a living cat's ass. You know what? I am rambling. I should bring somebody out because, you know, your Dr. Cleaver would be nothing without his faithful assistant. So let's welcome him. He is my former lab partner and my third cousin once removed. It's Wolfgang, everybody! What the hell are you doing with those dancers?
I'm living my truth!
Oh,
loud and proud.
Again?
I don't just want to go through life. I want to grow through life.
Oh, like a bumper sticker.
I've decided I identify as pulse-sexual.
Pulse-sexual? What's that?
If it has a pulse, I have sex with it.
Oh, that's perfect.
And the pulse part is negotiable.
Yeah, I guess.
Besides, those dancers, it's so hard to get paid around here. They needed that $20 more than they needed their dignity.
Well, if they needed their dignity, they wouldn't have taken this gig. Now, come on.
Speaking of this gig, I'm confused, Doctor.
Okay.
The Green Witch said she was bringing dead hosts back to life to be here tonight.
Yeah, it's the plot, flimsy as it is.
Oh, you won't.
We're actors in a theme park, Wolfgang. We just wish we were. I knew I should have been a doctor. Anyway, Wolfgang, the reason I brought you here is because I know that you love Halloween.
Oh, I do, I do, Doctor, I love Halloween.
Because it's
I love Halloween, like Will Smith loves a bitch slap. I love Halloween, like Gwyneth Paltrow loves vagina scented candles.
All right, it depends on the
time. I love Halloween like R. Kelly loves a middle school dance with no chaperones.
All right.
I love Halloween.
I get it, gang. You love Halloween like Kanye loves Kanye. But here's the deal. It's great that you're excited about Halloween, but these people are excited too. Now, they have certain expectations, so we're going to bring the lights up and do some in-your-face comedy. Seriously, what a bunch of Ugmos, am I right? I mean, that makes you miss the pandemic when at least our masks would cover up about half of that. But, you know, the rumor is they're paying us, Wolfgang, so let's go out and meet the great unwashed public. Oh, all right, that's enough of that. Well, Wolf, oh, there, no better up close. Oh, I've heard so much about you. What was your name? Penelope.
Yes, you did that for me.
Well, let's check in with her in 10 years and see what she's up to. All right, let's keep going. Oh, there's a lot of phones in my face. Oh, no, it's okay. Go ahead. All right, well, now you don't want to. Screw you then. Oh! Oh, thank goodness, another child. I thought I'd go a block and a half without seeing another one. How are you doing? Good. What's your name? Correct. Abigail. Well, how old are you? Oh, 9. Well, this is perfect then. 9 is reasonable. We have done our charity work for the night, Wolfgang. Let's head back up to the stage. Seriously, who the hell is that? He's got eyebrows like that Schitt's Creek boy. Now listen, Wolfgang, that was fun. If you like that sort of thing. But we are about to take this show into the dark heart of America.
Arlado!
Okay. But politically similar. We're going to take these people someplace that will stop them dead in their tracks like Mitch McConnell at a press conference.
Oh,
I'm gonna need your help, Penelope, when you grow up and have a career. All right, let's go, Wolfgang.
You go on ahead, Doctor.
Oh,
I have an appointment.
Oh, what's that?
Angel, I'm coming!
Already? You haven't even unzipped your pants. Get back over here. Now listen, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to head down south. We're headed to the bayou, home of voodoo and witches and the Shadow Man. We're headed to New Orleans. Let's go!
Yeah.
right, Tinkerbell, I love to hang out with underage boys. Here are my boys in berries. So juicy. All right, ladies and boys, you know what? I'm sorry, I'm gonna need some help up. Gravity's working against me. Just give me a look. All right, put your backs into it. All right, okay, now you know I'm top heavy. Now I need a tit lift. Now, I know you're looking at my trademarks. They can be a burden sometimes, but they also come in handy. First of all, they get me lots of work. Next month, I'm appearing in The Hills Have Eyes. Death on Memory Lane. And I can use them for fun fantasies. Look, I'm driving to San Diego. There's that nuclear power plant. And if things get really bad, I can go work up the street.
Oh, but you come here. It's so cold.
Come on, man. Okay, come back. And go real slow. Oh, no, make eye contact. Really work that Velcro in the ear. Get in the middle, too. But careful, I lost a hot pocket down there. I need to see the crowd a little bit. Can I have just a little bit of lights? Oh, that one in the pink. We're looking at you, lady. I see you chucking out my boys. Licking your lips like a Pekingese waiting for a begging strip. Don't give her a show for free. I'm watching you, lady. Nope. Mine. Boys, I don't trust that hussy of the Heights, hussy. You go over there because I look at her thighs. She could clear that pumpkin patch in one jump. Go ahead. Head over there a little bit. Oh my goodness. Makes me feel shame in my nether regions. Now, ladies and gentlemen, couldn't we get personal? I know that most of you women and several of you men want to be just like me. I know you look at me and you think, gosh, that's the ghoul that has everything. That bitch is hashtag blessed. But you know, I'm just a simple girl. And I have a heart that's right here under the nuclear power plant. And my feelings are a little bit hurt. I'm not happy with that green witch. Okay, so what's the deal? So she sacrifices some random guy to bring hosts back from the dead? Excuse me, homies, I got dead. Does this look like the body of a dead woman?
Yes!
What? Yes! Shut up, you sexy assholes. You believe in knots on them? I can't believe, you know what, make yourself useful. Take the couch out to the U-Haul. Be careful with it, it's a rental. You know we have that stupid show for the sick kids hospital tomorrow. Sorry, Abigail. Get out of here. You know, I have dildos with higher IQs than you. At least they're useful. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I am so sorry that you haven't watched that little personnel issue. But like my mom always said, sometimes life gives you lemons, and you have to take them, shove up someone's ass, and say, squeeze me some lemonade, bitch. Right, Angel? Angel will squeeze lemonade for you that quick. Well, look, now they're not even coming back. Put down the steroids at the cliff bars and get back out here. Ay, Dios mío, they did it again. I'm gonna need a Swiffer wet jet. Okay, I'm gonna stand right here. Get a little closer. Turn around, show me your talent. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen. The time has come for me to go. Oh yeah, I saw my Apple Watch. I got all my steps, so I'm gonna bounce out of here. But listen, ladies and gentlemen, I did want to let you know, I work 100% freelance now, so I am available to come to your place of business or corporate event for motivational speaking, management training, and team building. Abigail, I also do children's parties. All right, boys, drag me to hell.